morning and welcome to the Berks County Board of Commissioners meeting for March the 16th. We'll begin with a moment of silence followed by a pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Are there any additions or corrections from the March 9th Commissioner meeting minutes? Hearing none, the minutes will stand approved as presented. Is there any public comment on specific agenda items? Hearing none, we'll move into the agenda. Item one, under authorizing budget department, adopt a resolution authorizing 2016 budget transfers in the amount of $1,245,518. 2016 appropriations in the amount of $376,200, 2017 budget transfers in the amount of $69,665, and 2017 appropriations in the amount of $6,261 per listing dated March 13th. A couple of items listed under Human Services. Item one, authorize the appointment of Anthony Frost to investigator in the Public Defender's Office. Item two, authorize the appointment of Paul Bradshaw to assistant county solicitor procurement in the solicitor's office. We have one item under purchasing, adopt a resolution authorizing the award and the director of contracts and procurements to execute as a result of a request for a proposal, a contract for a two-year term to provide engagement and reintegration services to juvenile probation, youth, and families as identified herein. This goes to Justice Works out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Year one is a not to exceed amount of $86,550. Year two is a not to exceed amount of $86,700. Under facilities, we have one item, adopt a resolution authorizing the Director of Facilities and Operations to execute a change order to an agreement with Shannon A. Smith, Inc. for Berks County Services Center Courthouse Elevator Modernization Project in the amount of $16,126.91. This is a change order to furnish labor and materials associated with electrically connecting cars B and C in the county courthouse to emergency power so that they will continue to function in the event of a power loss. Under the commissioners, adopt a resolution ratifying, confirming, and approving Kevin S. Barnhart, vice chair, to execute the declaration of disaster emergency occurring March 14th for the county of Berks due to winter storm Stella. That was done. We are ratifying that action. And fortunately, to the best of our knowledge, there's been no serious outcomes as a result of Stella, the blizzard. Item two, a motion authorizing the chair of the board to execute contract agreements and amendments as furnished by the contract coordinator per attached listing dated March the 14th. There are two total contracts, one with the Area Agency on Aging and one with the Berks County Residential Center. And then finally, a motion to ratify and confirm payments is set forth in the Controller's Office voucher. The listing is dated March the 14th for the week ending March the 15th, and the payment of electronic transfers and employees payroll. And I think everybody just saw us sign that document, which is now with our chief clerk.
Motion to approve the agenda as presented.
I'll second that motion.
Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The motion is carried. And with that, we'll turn to Dennis Adams, our county treasurer, for the treasurer's report.
Good snowy morning.
Yes, it is.
I bought a snow blower, finally broke down, bought one. I thought, well, this will keep the snows away, but it didn't work. I guess it's my fault. Anyways, the opening balance today is $122,591,446.59. We have a balance to clear of $6,954,339.67, leaving us with a balance of $115,637,106.92.
Very good. And now our controller, Sandy Graffius, with your report.
Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning.
General accounts payable, $2,537,654. We had wire transfers of $3,959,680. We did not have a payroll this week for a grand total of $6,497,334.93.
Thank you very much. We'll turn now to our Chief Financial Officer for a report on the agenda for this afternoon's budget operations meeting.
Good morning, Commissioners.
Good morning.
We have an update today of a presentation. It's called the Boss Presentation by the folks from Sinking Springs. Has something to do with the Redevelopment Authority
as well. Springsteen.
Yeah. Baby, We Were Born to Run.
Yes.
The Boss.
Yeah. Is that what it means?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
No.
It's Boss 2020.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're pulling your leg, as in the Boss, Bruce Springsteen.
Never heard of him.
Oh, we're trying.
You're supposed to pick it up on the other end, and you fell miserably.
Reversing the co-host with Kelly Ripa. So
I'm just kidding. I've been to 5 concerts of his.
Okay.
Maybe 6. I'm not sure. But I'm not like one of these people been to 150.
Bob Williams, how many have you been at?
He's been probably 100.
About 100.
Yeah.
100 Springsteen concerts. Any one better than the other? I mean,
they're all great.
The last one's always.
I would agree. I would agree with that.
If you can afford.
Okay, back to the business at hand.
Anyway,
Boss 2020, the folks from Sinking Spring to present the long-term plan for revitalization of that area.
That is correct, Commissioner, and that starts at 3 p.m. today.
Very good.
Thank you.
And now, Ron Seaman for our report from Chief Administrative Officer.
Thank you, Commissioner Leinbach. Just one slight amendment. In addition to what Mr. Patrizio reported, it will be a very brief presentation on a proposed contract with the Reading Parking Authority for the Walnut and Poplar Garage following the Boss 2020 presentation. Second of all, I would like to thank the Board of Commissioners and the President Judge for their cooperation in moving towards deciding how we were going to face the impending storm on this past Tuesday, and then extend my personal thank you and appreciation to the facilities and maintenance staff for the excellent job they did in maintaining County Welfare Road, as well as the properties owned by the county. And secondly, to Mr. Gottschall and his staff at DES and the Communications Center. Fortunately, there were no major incidents that needed attention, but nonetheless, they manned the ship well. And then moving on to our 24-hour operations for custodial care of residents at the Berks Heim, the residential center and the prison, and the fine cooperation we had from all of their staffs in helping each other. Truly, the teams are to be commended. Thank you.
Very good.
Thank you.
We'll turn to Commissioner Barnhart.
Thank you. I, too, would like to echo the comments by Mr. Seaman about the teamwork experienced by the county staff, especially the jail Lieutenant Himmick and his maintenance staff when called upon by facilities and operations to help with County Welfare Road. They didn't hesitate to come down with their equipment and helped to salt and really make that viable for hundreds of, if not thousands of people traveling that road, whether going to work or visiting their loved ones at the nursing home. One other item I have, and hopefully we have it figured out with BCTV, and I don't know if it's any particular order. As you know, we have readingbridges.net, public-private partnership of government and the chamber and others involved in the initial closure of the Buttonwood Street Bridge, which will eventually be reopened probably in April now due to the storm Stella, which has inundated the bridge, and we'll have to find it somewhere down the road. But we're looking at the changeover to the Penn Street Bridge and the lane restrictions that will take place for at least 2.5 years. The Reading Bridges met last Friday, and through the support of the Greater Reading Economic Partnership and their relationship with Susie Ray Design, has come up with some really catchy promotional material. We look at this not as a distraction, but mm-hmm. a real benefit for people to recognize that this was the long-term improvement to Buttonwood and Penn Street for many years to come. So we're really taking it to heart. We actually are going to have a billboard put up by commuter services who are engaged heavily with this project. It'll be on the bypass. Say the Penn Street ramp is closing, but downtown Reading is not. Find your way at readingbridges.net. So our team came up with the Find Your Way at readingbridges.net as a tagline for everything we use to promote the fact that it's a little bit different. When Buttonwood went down, West Reading didn't close. There were lane restrictions as far as turning on 3rd and 4th Avenue, but we feel it's going to be a particular concern for the business owners in the 2, 3, and 400 block of Penn Street when there will be one lane coming into Reading and two lanes going out. So we're working with many of the merchants, especially Mike Leifert, the Peanut Bar, will also come up with new traffic patterns. Downtown Reading is open for business, showing you the detours, using Downtown Improvement District's logo, Destination Downtown Reading, and easing people down the Binghamton Street Bridge or Lancaster Avenue Bridge, or if they miss that, coming up eastbound from the Exeter area to make the detour through the North Wyomissing Boulevard and come back through Wyomissing down through West Reading. So this all in an effort to continue to support the merchants, the business owners, the Goggle Works, the Entertainment Square, and everyone in that several block quadrant when it is lane restricted, that we're still open for business. The merchants are going to be putting ads out, encouraging people through GPS and other methods that they're certainly back open for business and continue to stay open. City has supported us with wayfind signage to the tune of about $8,000 or $10,000 worth of signs. We're going to be using the same logos, so it's really colorful and cheerful as we weather this lane restriction to help and support the downtown merchants. A lot at stake here. We want to make sure, we know the local people always seem to be able to find their way around. If they want to get to the Peanut Bar, they'll find their way. But it's generally, and Mike was telling us the other week, that he has a lot of customers come in from down the Exeter Amity Township area, and he wants to make sure they know that he's going to be open for business and can find a way to Judy's or the Peanut Bar or Ugly Oyster and places like that. So look more for this on our website, on every other website that we have engaged, the Chamber, GREP, the City of Reading, and we want to make this as pleasurable an experience as possible for the motorist coming back and forth through Reading and West Reading and other places. So thank you. Hopefully it's scrolled right on BCTV because I couldn't really see it, but how'd it look, John?
Great.
Okay, good. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner Scott.
It's good to know that Dennis Adams has a snowblower. I'm curious, does Mr. Troutman have a snowblower?
A tractor?
I take it that's because Mercedes doesn't make a snowblower, is that right? That's all I have.
No, that was worth waiting for. couple quick items. First of all, I also want to add my thanks to everyone, not just here in the county, our facilities, for the work they did to clean up and make sure this place was ready yesterday morning to reopen. For Brian Gottschall and his team at 911. Brian and I actually did an interview on feedback Tuesday morning at a little bit after 9, and it was interesting. Brian said it was so uneventful that they actually had less activity during the snowstorm than they did on a normal Tuesday. And the reason he believes, and I think he's probably right, is that a large number of people heeded the warning of the governor and others to stay off the roads. A lot of businesses closed or cut back dramatically. And the bottom line is there was hardly anyone on the road. And I think that led to a much safer situation. I had laugh. I maybe I don't know if I'd say I would laugh or not, but yesterday morning we came in and the commissioners were greeted with an email from an individual that works here in the county, I won't go any further than that, blasting us for being open, saying that in their 25 years of working here at the county, this is the worst decision and worst conditions they've seen coming into work. And I hate to tell you, they drove in, I believe, from Wyomissing area. So that comes under the category, you just can't please everybody. My response back was, sorry that you had a rough ride in, but I just drove in from the Hamburg area and intentionally drove back roads the whole way, and it wasn't that bad. There were a couple places I think I had single lane because of drifting snow, but
I just wish Bob Patrizio wouldn't have sent you that email.
Yeah. Well, Bob Patrizio lives in Chester County, which we've been working to rectify that problem, but it wasn't Bob Patrizio. So it just helps people understand that even when you make what seems to be an obvious decision, there's always somebody not happy. I'll let you suggest that the next time
we'll take
that complaint.
Take Barta.
That would have been a better idea. Barta was back.
We need the revenue.
The last item I want to note is last Thursday at 1 o'clock, we had a meeting on the Reading 120. I'm not going to reiterate what took place, but I want to make clear where we are because there still seems to be a little bit of confusion. The city of Reading has agreed to look at this from the standpoint of it being handled by Reading Rec and Park Commission. They were supposed to meet on Tuesday evening. For obvious reasons, that was not an option. They did not meet. I assume they're going to reschedule. That is a critical piece. They're meeting to determine whether they're willing to take over the financial responsibility and the organizational responsibility. If they say yes, I think the next thing that should happen, the Reading Eagle should reconsider its involvement with Pretzel City Productions. They were very involved last year. They were a critical piece of the success relative to sponsors, Dave Klein, Alicia, who worked for Pretzel City Productions, very much like to get them back in. Penske reached out to me couple of days after the meeting, and if this is resolved, they will be back in as well. And then from a county standpoint, once we know where the Reading Parks and Rec Commission stands, then we have a decision to make. Mayor Wally Scott very graciously announced that he's going to meet with his distant cousin, Commissioner Mark Scott. I jest. I don't think there's any actual relationship, but who knows?
There might be.
He might be your long-lost cousin? Or
he's Scots Irish. His family actually went to Maine.
Okay, there's an idea.
There's a
ancestry.
The Recorder of Deeds has suggested a DNA test.
Yeah. Okay.
Put this to rest.
There may be.
So, for those that are waiting for the county to take the next step is not in the hands of the county. It's in the hands of the Reading Rec and Park Commission. They actually have an event tonight at the Doubletree, fundraising event for Reading Rec and Park Commission. I'll be at that event, and I had made plans to attend that before there was any Reading 120 controversy. So, hopefully, I'll get a little bit more information on where they are on rescheduling. That's all that I have. Anything from our row officers? Yes, Sandy.
I appreciate you putting the paper, the county website, which is www.countyofberks.com. And on the left-hand side of the page, the homepage, you can go to the controller's department, and there will be listed the cheat checks. We have the file out there now. For 2014 and 2015. If your name is there, please contact the controller's office and we'll see about reissuing your checks. And I would like to clarify the escheat process because I took some thunder away from the treasurer and I never want to do that. The Comptroller's Office takes care of the checks, takes care of getting the money back to the people. If, in fact, this doesn't happen, we send a handy-dandy list to the Treasurer's Office along with how much the check should be, and they are the ones that actually do business with the state. How's that, Denny?
That's true, but that's when it becomes an escheat, when we send it to the state.
So it becomes...
You're trying to refund people that didn't collect their checks.
I'm trying to refund people that did not collect their checks.
Ahead of the escheat process.
It's not in the escheat process at that point.
Correct. And Denny wanted to know if I wanted to take over the whole process.
I was trying to give it to her, because it's...
And I said, no, thank you, I pass, and that's why I'm trying to get this all sorted out so that the Treasurer's Office does not slide out of that obligation to the state.
What's the total value of this money?
The total value of the money is about $7,000.
$7,000.
Yeah.
Among how many people?
We have we have under 50 and over $50 that we sort for. Mm-hmm. And most of the under 50 are for jury checks, which are $9.76. But we will refund that to you, to the people. You know, it's funny, we'll send out letters to them and say, please contact us because we want to give you your money. And when we actually call them on the phone over a certain amount of money, they'll say, oh, well, we never open anything from the county. That's just junk mail, which drives me crazy. So please, if you get a letter, open your letter from the county. Honest, we really want to get your money back before Denny institutes the escheat process.
Keep in mind, once we escheat that money to the state,
right,
we can still go to the state and recover that money. If this is just a preliminary...
Isn't escheat Latin for the state steals your money? Is that what that...
I've not heard that, but...
Don't get me in that.
Look that up in your Latin dictionary. Yeah, $7,000 from Berks County.
I suggest everybody go out to the state site and check for escheat money, because I've talked to people over the years where there's huge amounts of money that gets put into the escheat fund because of relatives passing away or something and not realizing they actually have that money.
One of the other things we do in our office, and we haven't done it yet for this year, we go on the website and see if anything says County of Berks for a refund to the county. And then we go ahead and sign up to get the money, and then we drop it into the different bank accounts of the different departments. We just haven't done it this year because we're still working on our CAFR.
Okay.
Good information.
Very good. Anything else? Anything from the public?
Motion to adjourn.
Meeting is adjourned.